This video will help you with any assignments that ask for the demand numbers or trends for a product. This will be especially useful for the ECON 704 class here at UW-Whitewater, but it can be useful for many other class assignments too. Many students faced with this question probably start with a query like this on Google, and sometimes you will find valid stats there. However, most of the time you'll find the sales page for some single title market research report like this, or press release announcements for these. Here are several examples of market research reports I got just from the first page of Google's results. However, in my experience, most of these reports you find via Google are not high quality at all. Here are some warning signs of poor quality market research reports. There is no author's name. They predict trends more than 5 years away. It's almost impossible to be accurate that far out. Sometimes grammar or sentence structure errors indicate that the reports are generated very quickly with poor editorial oversight. Worst of all, you'd have to pay a very high price to get one single report. Don't pay for these reports. Even if they give you any numbers for free, you should still proceed with caution. This is just a sales page that tells us very little about their methodology or how they come up with these numbers. As with any information source, evaluate their numbers and compare to other sources to see if they seem reasonable. Instead of spending time there, I recommend you go to our library's subscription databases for resources that we've already purchased and quality verified for you. Get to these via the library's homepage, the Articles Databases button, then select Business from the subject drop-down menu, and go to the database name you want. For demand information, I recommend these databases. First, IBIS World, then Statista, and finally Business Premium Collection and Business Source Complete. Here's IBIS World. Search for the general industry. These reports are often at the broad industry level, not always the product, so if you can't find a report for water bottles, try the slightly broader industry, like plastic bottle manufacturing. All of the reports have the same chapter structure. On the first page, industry definition carefully delineates what is and isn't included in this industry. Check here first to make sure that this report matches the good or service that you're studying. This report includes plastic packaging containers sold to other brands, like Kraft Foods or Coca-Cola, but it doesn't include those reusable plastic containers or bottles sold directly to consumers, brands like Tupperware or Contigo. Next, go to the Key Statistics section for demand numbers, both in the past and projected out for 5 years. Here, domestic demand is computed as revenues plus imports minus exports. Finally, go to the Industry Performance tab, where they have a current performance section. The chart shows the previous few years of revenue trends, plus be sure to read the analysis on this page to help you understand some things that drive changes in demand. It may talk about elasticity of demand here, even if they don't use the word elasticity specifically. All of these IBIS World reports can be downloaded in full as a PDF, and you can also use this box on the top left to search within the report for anywhere they use a key term, such as demand. Need help in citing these unusual business resources? All the citation information needed is contained at the top of the report page, with the exception of the URL. You don't want to use any of these long URLs if you can see libproxy in it. That means you logged into our off-campus proxy server, and the URL is not going to work for anyone not at UWW, and it might break even for those who are at UWW. So instead, see this example. You just use the database name and then the homepage URL for the entire database itself. Pause the video here and follow this correct citation example for yours. If you can't find relevant reports and numbers in IBIS World, or if you'd like to confirm your numbers, check another source or two. Statista is a good source for statistics in graph and chart form. Search for your industry or product name. You might try adding demand, or possibly revenue, sales, or volume. Some of Statista's charts are time series, and sometimes they'll be predicted out for future years. Like in this chart, 2012 is actually the last real number, and the 2017 number has an asterisk, meaning it's a prediction, so take that with a grain of salt. However, Statista always gives the source of their data in this box here. That can give you a good source to go check their website to see if they collected any newer data. A lot of these surveys are done by professional associations for companies in that industry, and sometimes they'll make stats available on their website. Here's a citation example for you to follow for citing Statista. All the information needed is in the graph's title or the source box, except for the retrieval information. Again, just use the database name and then the homepage URL. not that long libproxy URL from the top of your database window. Finally, another place to look for demand, numbers, and trends is in the various business magazines, like Harvard Business Review, newspapers, like the Milwaukee Business Journal, and trade journals, like Packaging Digest, published for a particular industry. The easiest way to search for these is to go to our big business article databases, Business Premium Collection and Business Source Complete, because these search a whole bunch of business articles all at once. Search with keywords like you did in Statista, say, plastic bottles demand. You'll notice I use quotation marks around the phrase plastic bottles here. The quote marks tell the database to search for those words as a phrase right next to each other, so you should get fewer, more relevant results. To limit further, try using the filters on the left-hand side. I probably want results in the last 5 or maybe 10 years, and I'll start by looking at trade journals. I could also try adding or maybe modifying a search word or two, but I'll stick with my original search for the moment. Here's an interesting, pretty recent article from a supply chain trade journal. It may not talk specifically about plastic water bottles, but about plastic packaging trends in general and how they're affected by COVID, which could add to your analysis. Be sure you try similar searches in both of our big business article databases, because they do cover some different titles. Here you can see very different results for the same search in Business Source Complete. Number one looks like a relevant article from the trade journal called Beverage Industry. For any assignment asking you to study demand, you may not find one 100% accurate number that matches your specific product and the exact years you want. You'll often need to check lots of different sources, compile various numbers and estimates, look at industry experts' analysis, and draw reasonable conclusions. That's just part of business research. However, if you're feeling frustrated or stuck, don't hesitate to contact the library. We're happy to help.